Hello Storyboarders, my name is Eric, and today I'm going to show you how to make one of my personal favorites, graphic novel templates, using one of Storyboard That's pre-made templates. So let's get started. Now first we're going to pick out one of the pre-made templates, and you have a lot of choices and a lot of fun patterns and designs, but I like this one, so just click the copy template button below, and this will bring you straight into the Storyboard Creator, which will then prompt you to give your storyboard a name. So I'm just going to call this template one, and then click continue. All right, now it's time for us to customize our template. This is where we get to make any changes, add any characters, text, whatever we want to do. So first, I would like to add a character. So if you go up to your characters menu, and I'd like to add a superhero. And superheroes will be under monsters and myths, and you got a few choices here in the beginning. I like this character. So just drag and drop them into your storyboard, which will then prompt you to customize your character. Now you can make any changes you want, update facial expressions, poses, other specific characteristics, whatever you would like to do. So I would like my superhero to fly. Let's see. I think that's pretty good. Now you can select colors here on the right, or you can hit the randomize color button and it will change the colors at complete random, which can be really fun. I like that one. Now when your character is all set, just click update pose. Now you can move them anywhere you want in your storyboard, as well as resize them. Just drag the corner of the image, and there you go. You can also rotate your character. Just go to the top center button and drag to rotate. All right, I think that's pretty good. Now next is items. You can browse the items category, or you can search for items in the upper right-hand search menu. Now, I'd like to have a helicopter in here. So if we go back to the items category, and under vehicles, should be able to find a helicopter. Oh, here we go. Just drag and drop, just like your character. And let us rotate that. You can flip it in the right-hand menu. And let's make that a little bit smaller so we have a sense of scale with our superhero. You can also update the colors in the right-hand menu here. Let's make it green. I think we have some other stripes in there too. Let's change those. Okay, great. Now next is backgrounds. Now you can change any of the backgrounds that you want that come with your template. Just change the color in the right-hand menu, whatever you would like to do. Now you can also add a background. All you have to do is go up to your scenes and you can select anyone from up here. Now I like this white, but I think I'd like something a little bit more dramatic. So I'm gonna go over to patterns and let's add a really dark color. So you can take this one, just drag and drop it. And in your right hand menu, let's stretch to fill. And then click okay. Now once you have your scene in place, just send it to the back of your template. And there we go. Now next is text. Now you can update any of the pre-existing text boxes. All you have to do is select what you want to change and put in your own words. So let's have them saying something. Great. You can also change the font as well as its size. Just highlight what you want to change and go over to your text editor. And I'm going to pick out a new font that feels a little bit more comic book based. This one looks good. Let's make that a touch, I'll make it a touch bigger. All right, now just like the characters, you can change the size as well as move your text box around. So let's line that up a little bit better and let's stretch it out to make the text box bigger. Now, since we have a graphic novel, we have all these fun sound effects. Now, I think the splat is pretty cool, but I'd like to have something a little bit different. So if you go up to your speech bubbles, you have all different text boxes to choose from, as well as some action sound effects. So let's delete this one and let's pull down this boom. Just drag and drop and we can stretch to fill. All right, great. Now, when you're all done with your template, all you have to do is click the orange save and exit button that's down in the bottom right-hand corner of your screen. And that is how you make a graphic novel using Storyboard That. All right, thanks for watching and happy storyboarding.